Hello everyone, welcome to the MICA classes. I am going to discuss about the June month most important current affairs in MICA. Let's start with the appointment portion. We are on a page number 11 and let's see what are the appointments on page number 11. We have first appointment J.S. Rajput. The Union Government, this is the most important paragraph. Union Government has nominated Professor J.S. Rajput. He is a Professor Rajput and he has been appointed by the Union Government as the India's representative to the Executive Board of UNESCO. Okay, I hope you are getting my point. He was the former director of NCERT. To know about UNESCO, basically the headquarter of UNESCO is located in the Paris, France. Paris, France is the headquarter of the UNESCO. In an examination, generally examiner asks about the full form of UNESCO. So UNESCO stands for United Nations Educational, Scientific and the Cultural Organization. And for this news, you have to remember J.S. Rajput has been appointed as the India's representative to the Executive Board of the United Nations Educational, Scientific and the Cultural Organization. Next, we have appointment, that is what? Javed Rahim. Javed Rahim has been appointed by the Supreme Court. This is the most important paragraph. Supreme Court appointed Justice Javed Rahim. He is a Justice Javed Rahim as the acting president of the National Green Tribunal. At present, Mr. Javed Rahim is in the judicial member of the NGT. He is a judicial member of NGT. But now he has been appointed as the acting president. Basically, acting president means the short-term president for a short-term and for temporary purpose. And as an ad hoc, you can understand as an ad hoc president. So guys, please remember, Supreme Court has appointed Mr. Javed Rahim as the acting president of the National Green Tribunal. Next, we have most important appointment, that is what? Ms. Indu Bhushan. Mr. Indu Bhushan. Indu Bhushan was appointed CEO of the Ayushman Bharat National Health Security Mission. If you have remember, Mr. Honorable President of India, Honorable Finance Minister of India, Arun Jaitley has announced the Ayushman Bharat National Health Security Mission in budget. And government has already approved this scheme. Now government has appointed Indu Bhushan as the CEO of the Ayushman Bharat National Health Protection Mission. Now guys, we are on page number 12 and I have most important appointment. Let's start with the M. Satyavati. M. Satyavati took charge as the member of the UPSC. Guys, here is most important name of a one person who is the UPSC chairman. Vinay Mittal is the chairman of the UPSC, Union Public Service Commission. And apart from, M. Satyavati has taken charge as the member of the UPSC. This paragraph is the most important for your examination and you have to remember only two names. One is the Vinay Mittal, who is the chairman of the UPSC. And another name of the person is the M. Satyavati, who took charge as the member of the Union Public Service Commission. This is more than enough for your examination. And she is a M. Satyavati who has taken charge as the UPSC member. Next is the Vijay Chafekar. Inspector General Vijay Chafekar. Guys, please remember name of a person. Vijay Chafekar, he is a Mr. Vijay Chafekar, has been appointed as the Coast Guard Commander, Western Region. There are many reasons, North Region, South Region, East Region, and he has been appointed as the Coast Guard Commander of the Western Region, and the name of a person is the Vijay Chafekar. Vijay Chafekar took over charge from the Inspector General K.R. Nautiyal. Before appointing Vijay Chafekar as the Coast Guard Commander, K.R. Nautiyal was working as the Coast Guard Commander. So he has replaced the Mr. K.R. Nautiyal and now he will work as the Coast Guard Commander. So name of a person is the Vijay Chafekar. Next appointment is the Bhanu Pratap Sharma, B.P. Sharma. He is a Mr. B.P. Sharma and he has been appointed as the new chairman of the Bank Board Bureau. Bank Board Bureau basically work for the appointment of the bank's head. And now Bhanu Pratap Sharma has been appointed as the chairman of the Bank Board Bureau. Triple B stand for the Bank Board Bureau. He was the chairman of the recruitment, for he was the former chairman of the recruitment and assessment center of the DRDO. DRDO stand for Defense Research Development Organization. Basically, these are the three most important appointments. This is the fourth most important appointment on the page number 12. And the name of the person is the Shri Priya Ranganathan. Shri Priya Ranganathan, this is the most important point. Shri Priya Ranganathan has been appointed as the next ambassador of India to the Republic of Korea. Basically, Republic of Korea means the South Korea. South Korea, if you know about the fact of the South Korea, what is the capital of the South Korea is the Seoul, S-E-O-U-L. And the currency of South Korea is the won. Now, Shri Priya Ranganathan will be the next ambassador of India to the Republic of South Korea. That means South Korea. And guys, please remember the capital is the Seoul and the currency of South Korea is the won. Another one liner news is the 106th edition of Indian Science Congress will be held in Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. Guys, most important news. Examiner definitely asked this question. 106th edition of Indian Science Congress will be held in which city? So answer is the Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. And please remember Shri Priya Ranganathan. She is a Shri Priya Ranganathan who has been appointed as the next ambassador to India to the Republic of the Korea. Now we are on page number 13. And here most important news. And the news is related to the Abel Prize. Basically, who has been awarded with the Abel Prize? Now, Canadian mathematician Robert Langlands was awarded with the 2018 Abel Prize for his revolutionary Grand Unified Theory of Mass. For the theory, the name of our theory is the Grand Unified Theory of Mass. For this theory, Mr. Robert Langlands has been honored with the Abel Prize. He is a Canadian mathematician. So basically, you have to remember the fact of the Canada. Capital of Canada is the Ottawa. And the currency of Canada is the dollar. And the Prime Minister of the Canada is the Justin Trudeau. Please remember, capital of Canada is the Ottawa. Currency of Canada is the dollar. And the Prime Minister of the Canada is the Justin Trudeau. And apart from a study fact, you have to remember who has been honored with the Abel Prize, 2018 Abel Prize. So answer is the Canadian mathematician Robert Langlands has been awarded with the, has been honored with the 2018 Abel Prize. Basically, know about, there are a few terms related to the Abel Prize. It is named after Norwegian mathematician Niels Henrik Abel. And the Abel Prize was first awarded in the year 2003. Basically, examiner asked some questions ki in which year the particular award has instituted. So answer is Abel Prize was awarded first in 2003 and it is named after the Norwegian mathematician Niels Henrik Abel. The award acknowledges outstanding scientific work in the field of the mathematics. And the award comes with the monetary award of rupees US dollar 776000. And last point, some of the previous winners of the award, you can easily read, and this is not for your examination. You can just read for your knowledge purpose. But please remember who has been honored. So answer is the Canadian mathematician Robert Langlands. National Water Digest Award. Still we are on page number 12. Chhattisgarh was awarded National Water Digest Award for water conservation, diversion and the increasing the irrigation capacity in the state. Point number two, the award was presented to the Chhattisgarh Water Resource Department and on the occasion of the World Forestry Day. Basically, examiner can ask on which day World Forestry Day was observed. So answer is the March 21 in New Delhi. Basically, who has been awarded with the National Water Digest Award? So answer is the Chhattisgarh was awarded with the National Water Digest Award for water conservation, diversion and the increasing the irrigation capacity in the state. There are some key factors. Basically, you can read, this is the first time that the CWRD was given national award during the 17 years. Chhattisgarh bagged this award for increasing irrigation capacity. We have learned in the starting paragraph. Water management, water diversion, water conservation, community participation, effort towards interlinking of rivers. This is the most important point. Better techniques utilized in irrigation facilities. So please remember only these facts. These are sufficient for your examination. Next award is the BAFTA, B-A-F-T-A. Veteran actor Mr. Anupam Kher secured a nomination in the Best Supporting Actor category at the British Academy Television Award 2018 for his role in the drama The Boy with the Top Knot. Basically, for which drama he has been nominated for a BAFTA award? So answer is the Boy with the Top Knot. Who has been nominated for the BAFTA award in the Best Supporting Actor category? So answer is the Anupam Kher. This is sufficient for your examination. I'll discuss point to point that is material for your examination, and you have to remember only one point, that who has been nominated for the BAFTA award in the Best Supporting Actor category. So answer is the veteran actor Anupam Kher. Apart from, already we have discussed, Canadian mathematician Robert Langlands has won the Abel Prize for 2018. We are on page number 14. And now we have still some awards. Dadasaheb Phalke Excellence Award. Here you can see in image Anushka Sharma, but Anushka Virat Kohli Sharma and Ranveer Singh. And about these awards, now we are going to discuss. Actor Ranveer Singh and the actress Anushka Sharma will receive the Dadasaheb Phalke Excellence Award, most important award. Ranveer Singh will receive this award as the best actor for his movie Padmavat, while Anushka Sharma will receive this award for achieving excellence as the movie producer. So Anushka Sharma as the movie producer and Ranveer Singh as the best actor will receive the Dadasaheb Phalke Excellence Award. The award is being given by the Mumbai-based organization called Dadasaheb Phalke Foundation. Basically, Dadasaheb Phalke Excellence Award is different from the Dadasaheb Phalke Award. Dadasaheb Phalke Award is given by the Government of India. But Dadasaheb Phalke Excellence Award is given by the Mumbai-based organization called the Dadasaheb Phalke Foundation. This award and the organization is not same as the Government of India instituted Dadasaheb Phalke Award. Basically, I have told you, awarded during the National Award Ceremony held annually in New Delhi. This award is awarded during the National Award Ceremony, which held in New Delhi. And the Indian government, Dadasaheb Phalke Award is the most prestigious, the India's highest cinematic honor. Examiner generally asks which award is the highest cinematic honor in India. So answer is the Dadasaheb Phalke Award, which is given by the Government of India. 65th National Film Award, most important. We are still on a page number 14. Shekhar Kapoor was the chairman of the National Film Awards Committee. Guys, please remember who was the chairman of the National Film Awards Committee. So answer is the Shekhar Kapoor. Shekhar Kapoor has announced the 65th National Film Awards. We will discuss point to point who has been honored with the particular award. So Shri Devi posthumously has been conferred with the Best Actress Award. Please remember who has been conferred with Best Actress Award. So answer is the Shri Devi has been conferred with the Best Actress Award. The award for Best Hindi Movie has been conferred to the Rajkumar's Rao film Newton. Basically, Newton was nominated for the Oscar award, but it was not awarded for best film. But in the National Film Award, it has been honored as the best Hindi movie, and the movie was the Rajkumar's Rao's the movie. At the same time, a special award for film Newton has been awarded to the Pankaj Tripathi. Please remember. At the same time, a special award for the film Newton has been awarded to Pankaj Tripathi. The National Film Award is the most prominent film award ceremonies in India, established in 1954. Please remember, it was established in the year of the 1954. It has been administered along with the International Film Festival of India and the Indian Panorama by the Indian government's direct Directorate of the Film Festival since 1973. Basically, you have to remember in which year it is established. So answer is the 1954. Who has been awarded with the Best Actress? So answer is the Shri Devi. Who has been honored with the Best Hindi Movie? Which movie has been honored with the Best Hindi Movie? So answer is the Rajkumar Rao film Newton. And a special award for the film Newton has been awarded to the Pankaj Tripathi. Next point is the award categorized in three sections. One is the feature film, non-feature film, and the best writing on the cinema. Please remember, the award are categorized in three sections: feature films, non-feature film, and the best writing in cinema. It aims at encouraging the production of the film of the aesthetic, technical excellence, and the social relevance, contributing to the understanding and appreciation of the cultures of different regions of a country in cinematic form, thereby promoting utility and the integrity of the nation. Basically, this is not enough. This is not for your examination purpose. Then you can only read and skip. Now focus on the award. Dada Saab Phalke Award is given to Vinod Khanna. Please remember, most important. Who has been honored with the Dada Saab Phalke Award posthumously? So answer is the Vinod Khanna. Best Actress, already I told you. Best Actress given to Shri Devi for the Mom. Best Actor, Riddhi Sen, Nagar Kirtan. This is the most important part for your examination. Examiner can generally ask these questions related to the this award. So first is the Dada Saab Phalke Award. Another is the Best Actress Award, and next is the Best Actor, Riddhi Sen, Nagar Kirtan. Best Supporting Actress is the Divya Datta, Irada, Hindi film. Best Supporting Actor, Fahad Fazil. Best Producer Film, Bahubali 2. Best Director, Jairaj for Bhayankam Malayalam. This is a Malayalam movie. And Best Feature film is the Village Rockstar. This is the Assamese movie. And best film critic is the Giridhar Jha. Best regional film is the Ladakh. Best Marathi film is the Kacha Limbu. And best Malayalam film is the Thondi Muthulum Driksh Siyum. This is the most typical name in Malayalam. And best Hindi film, I already told you, Newton. Next, best Bengali film is the Mayurkshi. Best Assamese film is the Issue. Best Tamil film is the Tulat. Best Telugu film is the Ghazi. Best Gujarati film is the DHH. Best Kannada film is the Hobbitu Ramakka. Best action direction is again Bahubali 2. Too much typical name. And best choreography goes to Toilet Ek Prem Katha. Ganesh Acharya is the choreographer. Ganesh Acharya was the choreographer of the Toilet Ek Prem Katha movie. Best Special Effect, again Bahubali 2, Jai 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 Kara. Special Jury Award goes to Nagar Kirtan, again Bengali movie. And Best Music Direction is the A.R. Rahman for the Katru Valediyai. And Background Score is the A.R. Rahman for the Mom. This is the most important award, Raj Kapoor Lifetime Achievement Award and the Raj Kapoor Special Contribution Award. Mr. Dharmendra will be conferred with the Raj Kapoor Lifetime Achievement Award by the Maharashtra government. First of all, this award will be given by the Maharashtra state government, and Mr. Dharmendra will be conferred with the Raj Kapoor Lifetime Achievement Award. Apart from Dharmendra, Mr. Director Rajkumar Hirani will get the Raj Kapoor Special Contribution Award. There is two news. One is the Raj Kapoor Lifetime Achievement Award, and it will be given to Mr. Dharmendra. And again is the Raj Kapoor Special Contribution Award, and this will be conferred to Mr. Rajkumar Hirani, who is a director. Next and most important point is this. Actor Vijay Chavan and the actress director Mrinal Kulkarni on being announced as the recipient of the prestigious Chhatrapati V. Shantaram Jeevan Gaurav Puraskar and Chhatrapati V. Shantaram Vishesh Yoga Dan Puraskar respectively. It means Mr. Vijay Chavan will be conferred with the Chhatrapati V. Shantaram Jeevan Gaurav Puraskar and Mrinal Kulkarni, actress director, will be awarded with the V. Shantaram, Chhatrapati V. Shantaram Vishesh Yogadan Puraskar respectively. We are on page number 16 and the 17. Here I will discuss about the obituary portion. Generally in examination, examiner asks some person, he has passed away recently. He belongs to which field? This is the type case number 1 of question. Mr. XYZ has passed away recently. He belongs to which field? And Mr. Politician has passed away recently. What was the name of the politician and from which state he and she belongs to? So you have to remember these term and these questions. Start with the point number 1 and the news one. Bhai Vaidya, veteran socialist, leader, freedom fighter and the former state minister. Basically, state is the Maharashtra. He belongs to which state? So answer is the Maharashtra. So what you have to remember? Bhai Vaidya, he was the socialist leader, freedom fighter and the former Maharashtra state minister. He had participated in the Quit India movement in 1972 Goa freedom struggle and United Maharashtra movement. He was jailed 25 times during the various movements during the emergency in India. He had served 19 months in jail. Even at the age of 88, he was arrested after took part in the agitation for the educational rights, for educational rights basically. He was fondly addressed as the Bhai Vaidya, Vaidya who believed in value-based politics and had also participated in the 4000 km Padyatra from Delhi to Kanya Kumari, undertaken by Chandrasekhar in the 80s. He was member of the various committee in the civic body. But what you have to remember for your examination? Veteran socialist leader Bhai Vaidya, freedom fighter, socialist leader and the former Maharashtra state minister. Next is the Kolam Azeed. Malayalam actor Kolam Azeed has passed away recently. Generally, examiner can ask that Kolam Azeed has passed away recently. He was what? He was the actor and he was the Malayalam actor. And this is sufficient for your examination. Apart from, you have to remember only the name of a person and the field of a person. And next news is the Raj Kishore. And all know, very known personality, all know very well, Raj Kapoor was the veteran actor. Raj Kapoor, it's not a Raj Kapoor, it's a Raj Kishore. Raj Kishore was the veteran actor who has passed away recently. The actor was mainly seen in the supporting roles during 17 and 18. His most significant work till date has been Sholay. He worked in the Sholay movie and he was the actor. Again, from this news, you have to remember Raj Kishore and he was the actor. And this is sufficient. And next is the obituary is related to the person Brij Kishore. And Brij Kishore, gymnastic coach Brij Kishore of a sports authority of Telangana state has passed away recently. What do you have to remember? Brij Kishore is related to the which sport? He is related to the gymnastic. Brij Kishore is related to which field? He was the scientist. He belongs to sports, so you have to remember Brij Kishore is related to the sport. This is sufficient for your examination. And now and next and the last obituary of this page and the this news and this news session. So Fauji Sheikh Ramzan Qureshi. Fauji Sheikh Ramzan Qureshi, most important, and examiner definitely asked in a upcoming examination, what was the name of the Azad Hind Fauj veteran who has passed away recently? So name of a person was the Fauji Sheikh Ramzan Qureshi. Azad Hind Fauj veteran Fauji Sheikh Ramzan Qureshi passed away recently in Odisha. He belongs to which state? So guys, remember Odisha. He had fought alongside Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose in Burma and the Japan and also been imprisoned, reports India Times. Basically, what you have to remember? You have to remember only what is the name of the Azad Hind Fauj veteran person who has passed away recently? Fauji Sheikh Ramzan Qureshi, and he belongs to which state? So answer is the Odisha. Now we are on page number 18 and the 19, and here are some schemes. and most important scheme, Integrated Scheme for Development of Silk Industry, ISSDSI, Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, CCEA, most important abbreviation, approved the Integrated Scheme for Development of Silk Industry, a central sector scheme which will be implemented for next 3 years from 2017-18 to 19-20. Here are some important points. What is the full form of CCEA? CCEA stands for Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs. Which scheme has been approved by CCEA for the silk industry? So answer is the Integrated Scheme for Development of Silk Industry. What will be the time period of the scheme for the implementation? So answer is 3 years, and it will be started from the 2017 to 2019-20. Here are some four components of the scheme. Let's see what are the component. Point number one, research and the development, training, transfer of technology and IT initiative. Point number two, seed organization and farmers extension center. Point number three, coordination and market development for seed, yarn and the silk products. And point number four, quality certification system, QCS system, by creating a chain of silk testing facilities, farm based and post cocoon technology upgradation and the export brand promotion. These all are the component of the scheme. Let's see what is the financial outlay. This is the most important part of this scheme, and examiner definitely asks about the outlay. The cabinet has approved total allocation of rupees 2161.68 crore for the implementation of the scheme for 3 years from 2017-18 to 19-20. What is the financial outlay? 2161.68. What is the time period? 3 years. And the time period will be starting from the 2017-18 and it will be end on 2019-20. This is the most important point. Again, the scheme will be implemented by the Ministry of Textile through the Central Silk Board. The scheme will be implemented by the Ministry of Textile through the Central Silk Board. My question is the, what is the name of the Minister of Textile? So answer is the Smriti Irani is a Minister of Textile. She is also the Information and the Broadcasting Minister, and she is a Rajya Sabha MP from the Gujarat. These are the most important point. She is a Rajya Sabha MP from the Gujarat. She is an Information Broadcasting Minister and she is a Textile Minister, and the name of a minister is the Smriti Irani, Smriti Zubain Irani. Here are some important points, core objective of the scheme. You can read and understand easily, but please remember some points that financial outlay and time period, and it is announced by the CCEA. What is the full form of CCEA? Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs. And what is the name of the scheme? So answer is the name of the scheme is the Integrated Scheme for Development of the Silk Industry.